we are here to discuss our Right to Live National Peace Movement, which is a movement of the people. It's the MOP movement, M-O-P, MOP. We're going to mop our communities up, clean them up, and hopefully protect the lives of our young people. That's the purpose. Elevate our minds and illuminate our minds and our hearts, our spirit. The reality of it is that with all the efforts that are being made, we still have not managed to save the lives of our young people.
When I think about our history, reflecting back 400 years of misery, we went from African kings to human machines, whipped, chained, and trained to pickpocketing for free, but then told that we had no identity. It felt like thoughts of freedom was a waste of time because they bruised our bodies and crushed our minds. But we had a few heroes on the battle lines, such as Harriet Tubman or Dr. King. Leaders like these gave me a dream. They gave me hope, better yet a chance that I could do anything through all my circumstance. Our ancestors walked, fought, and protested just so we can live, but yet we're so selfish that we won't even give. And when I think about today and the roles we play, we should be ashamed, adding fuel to the flame. We use the N-word like it's a part of our name, replacing proper English with Ebonics and slang. Slow to forgive, but first to fight. We're poisoned by videos, making wrong look right. What happened to the movement? We lost our passion to clothes and fashion. We ignored our preachers and disrespected our teachers. Now we turn on the news to be guided by the mayor, but we must have forgotten about the power of prayer. So instead of treating each other like a different social class, it's time to rise up like a phoenix from its ash. It's time to carry the torch and live out the dream, because anything is possible when love is our thing. Thank you.